Got a video blog for you guys. This one comes from Marcus. He is in Germany. Subject's about stretch marks. What causes them, how to prevent them. If we have them, can we get rid of them? So let's get into this. Hey Greg, first of all, I want to thank you for all you've given us, especially myself. You've answered so many questions that have been floundering around in my head with these videos. You're a truly living inspiration for me. My number one person I look up to. And I can write many more things, but I don't want this to be long and boring. My name is Marcus. I've been working out for about 2 years now, and I'm currently living in Germany. I was born in Alabama. My dad's an American soldier, and my mom's German, so that makes me mixed. Okay. But enough on that. To my question, lately I've been seeing stretch marks appear on my shoulders towards my chest. I've really been scared of getting these while working out, and now they finally came. Is there any way to prevent them from coming or even getting any bigger? I would really like to know if you have any stretch marks yourself, and if so, where? I couldn't see them in on your videos. It'd be awesome to hear your answer on this. Thanks so much for inspiring me. All the best. Marcus, stay safe, Greg, and be careful cutting that wood. Peace. Good question, buddy, and definitely be careful on that wood. Stretch marks. God, this, you know, what causes stretch marks? Stretch marks is like if your skin's right here, right? That's your epidermis layer. Your outer layer is your skin, is your epidermis. Below that, your sub layers is your dermis layer. When your body goes through a rapid change, an increase or a decrease in size, the elasticity within the dermis layer reaches a point of max stretch, right? And then it starts to now tear. That tearing produces micro bleeding in there too. And that's the first start of a stretch mark. Usually it comes like in a very pinkish color, and then it'll turn to a reddish brown over time, to a brown, and then slowly over time, it'll dissipate into like a silvery or white, like scar tissue look, but never really matching the skin, always standing out and noticing it. It's very common. When I say that rapid change in weight loss or weight gain within the body, frequently among women with pregnancy, 90% of women have stretch marks due to that factor. Also, another common aspect of that is just going through puberty for a guy. You know, as he's going into that growth spurt where the natural testosterone levels with the steroid hormones are released, your body's growing faster than the skin's elasticity is really able to grow with it, causing those stretch marks. The other common occurrence comes with bodybuilding. Guys that are past the growth spurts and now just getting in shape, you know, lifting hard. People that do steroids, that increases the factor of stretch marks too because their muscles are growing faster than their ligaments and tendons and skin can keep up with, causing that ripping of the elasticity within the dermis layer of the skin, promoting that scar tissue stretch mark. The other effect that happens is a defect in the connective tissue of your actual genetics, meaning like if down your food chain, right, not your food chain, your family tree, where you have people that have a lot of stretch marks, that's a genetic issue. And that passes generation because of a defect in the connective tissue. Are they a bad thing, guys? And is it something that you want to like really hide? And I know some women that they have them and they wear certain outfits to hide those marks, or they won't wear a certain thing because it shows that mark. I know people that to prevent the visual sense of the stretch mark, they'll take tanning solution like self tanner, and they'll get a Q-tip. And for guys that are working out, bodybuilders, the stretch mark, and to answer your question, Marcus, yes, I do have stretch marks. I only have one. It's on my left side. So if this is, you know, from my bicep into my shoulder region, my chest, it's right here in my armpit. That's where most guys, for bodybuilders and stuff, have that stuff. Is right there. I don't have it on this side, but I do have it right here. And it's kind of white and pasty now, and it's a scar, but it kind of falls on the contour of the wrinkle anyway, so that's why it's really hard to see. But if you have it in other areas that are more pronounced, a lot of people take sun tanning lotion, those self tanners, they get a Q-tip and they apply it to that skin, that white pasty area, silver area, after it's been matured, that stretch mark, and let it tan, you know? And then they'll tan the entire body, but apply more applications to the actual stretch mark to help to diffuse it and help to make it look more natural and not so pronounced. But honestly, I think it's kind of like me cutting my hand off, man. I got these cuts right there, so it says like I'm a master carpenter, or maybe just, you know, I've been cutting wood long enough that, you know, it's not a matter if, just when you cut your hand off. So I'm kind of part of the good old boys club, you know? I kind of like it. It's like calluses on your hands, you know? Like a guy having calluses. You should, man. You're a hardworking guy. It means you work for a living, you know? You're not a pencil pusher. You know, you actually get in there and do shit. I like having calluses, man. I'm proud of those fucking calluses. I got one stretch mark here. Fuck yeah, man. Why not? Man, I go to the gym and I work out. That's what I do, you know? So, I mean, I'm proud of it, man. I wouldn't look at it as like a reject thing, or is it something to be like it's something to be ashamed of, man? It means that you've done something in your life, you know? You know, like scars. I tell you what, scars are just tattoos with better stories, guys. Some people go out there and they get their hand all inked up and everything else, or some people have a slice in there from a bullet wound or a knife wound or something like that. You know, that scar is just a tattoo of the better stories. So that's how I look at it, man. So you're part of an elite crowd, man. Membership. Well, let's say you had it, right, and you want to prevent it. Well, let's say you're a guy who's, that you know, in their 20s and looking to lose weight, right, and get in good shape. Knowing your body's going to go through that rapid change of size, or you're losing weight to the decrease in size, how can we prevent some stretch marks from occurring? We can. There's certain measures we can do to prevent that process from happening. And it's called moisturizer. You want to get some creams. Zeppelin, stop! You want to get some creams, aloe vera. I mean, you want to get like cocoa butter or shea butter for creams. 3-4 times a day, especially guys, if you're working out right on your under your armpit right here in your shoulder region. You want to be putting that there. That moisturizer is going to help the elasticity to stretch more and everything else to prevent those stretch marks. 3-4 times a day, right? I usually put lotion on and, you know, moisturize our skin every time we take a shower, you know? So every morning, every evening, you know, that's at least twice a day. If you guys are really pushing hard in the gym, put a little bit of extra tension right into the armpit region. That's where it's really stretching for the guys that are working out. But there's a lot of creams out there and stuff that they say, that, and their tagline is that we will get rid of the stretch marks. Not so much, guys. I don't believe the hype there. As long as it takes, and stretch marks take a while to develop, they take just as long to diminish and get rid of, and usually never fully unless you get with a dermatologist. And that can be quite expensive. There's creams that they have, there's steroidal creams that really help to increase the production of the collagen and elasticity production of the skin to get rid of those areas. The stretch marks can help to rebuild the cells. And there's a lot of laser treatments they do, and they can run you a couple $100, and it's like 3 or 4 treatments you need to do to get that done. So the over-the-counter creams really don't do anything. They can help to diminish it a little bit, but it's never going to get rid of it unless you go to a dermatologist and pay the big coin to get it done. I don't think it's a problem, guys. It's something that we can prevent if before we have them with just, you know, nice moisturizer, which is really good for the skin. And the moisturizer stuff you want to do, there's a couple of factors when you look at the label of what's in there that you want to, you know, really concentrate on. Aloe vera, which is a plant, right? You cut it off and it's like that cooling factor, you know, for sunburn. That cooling factor helps to decrease the inflammation, and also it helps prevent wrinkles. So aloe vera is something you want to see if that product has it. Vitamin E is really good because it helps to decrease the aging process of the skin cells. So vitamin E are pills you can take, or you can get them in capsules or liquid form, which is another thing I would suggest doing. If you start to see a stretch mark developing, you know, besides just moisturizing it, get vitamin E in those capsules. Open the capsules up to the liquid form and directly apply that vitamin E liquid to that stretch mark area. Massage it in there. Do that a couple times a day. It's going to really help to prevent any growing of the stretch mark and help to reduce it from all the inflammation and the tearing of it. Retinoid and I hope I say this right, lycomic acid. Are natural things within these creams. They help promote the collagen and elasticity production for the skin. Really good to have there too. Vitamin C is also 500 milligrams a day, 3 times a day, good for the skin. So those are all types of elements within these creams that are really good. But you know, when it comes down to it, guys, when you go to the gym, you're gonna sweat it out, right? You're gonna work hard and sweat. You know, that's a byproduct. A stretch mark might be a byproduct. It's all part of being part of that crowd, man. Don't look at it as like a birth defect or a birthmark or something. Look at it as a badge of honor. That's how I look at it. I wouldn't worry about it, man. You got stretch marks, man, because you're working hard and everything else. You know, I'd much rather have a stretch mark than a gut. You know what I mean? You know, so of the two, which one do you want? I'll take behind curtain number A, you know? I've got them. I know everyone I know that works out and stuff, they have them. The people that have really bad steroids or something, guys, that, you know, I don't know if you guys are just convinced to do them or not. I you know, obviously not listening to what I have to say. But if you guys are doing that stuff, you better put that vitamin E, you better put that moisturizer on those joints and around your shoulder region, or you're gonna have terrible stretch marks. They're gonna bleed all the way into your chest and stuff. Not a good thing. You know, the steroids, man, it's so easy to tell if somebody's on that, man, because your body grows out of proportions. You lose that symmetry. Your steroids is sucked into different parts faster than others, and you grow like kind of weird looking, and you have these stretch marks and the zits and the pimples, and it's just like, really, man? You know, obviously anyone get big on that shit, you know, so am I impressed with that? No, I'm not. I wouldn't be taking those guys, but just a natural process of working out and giving your all can produce and will produce stretch marks. If you aren't taking it slow and doing it the correct way, building from the foundation of the rock, you know, everything, it's that marathon, not the sprint aspect. So my suggestion, Marcus, if you have them, vitamin E, get the liquid capsules, put the vitamin E on the actual targeted region there. Moisturize with cocoa butter and shea butter every, you know, morning, evening, every time you take a shower at least. Really doing attention to that, you know, your shoulder, chest region. Get those creams and stuff, and look on the back and the ingredients. Make sure they have aloe vera and the glycolic acid and the retinoids and the vitamin C plus the aloe vera. All those things are really good to help to increase the elasticity, to help the collagen production, decrease the wrinkling process, the aging process, the inflammation process. So that's really going to be your best weapon, your arsenal here to go into war with this stretch marks. But at the end of the day, they probably are going to come. And when they come, the only way to really get rid of them is with a dermatologist, with laser treatments and some of their steroidal creams. But, you know, really, I wouldn't freak out about them, man. It's like a scar, man. It's just a tattoo with a better story. So, Marcus, I hope that helps, man. And, you know, I think I've kept this video blog somewhat short. I got a great video coming for you guys here in about 3 days. Tricep trifecta, man. This one's amazing. I'm editing it down right now. So that'll be up, I think, on Friday. All right, guys. All the best, man. Great place to help you stay fit.